assessment, it became clear that problems existed that required intervention from the commissioners. Foremost among them was the fast approaching deadlines for certification, clean and green enrollments, and other matters. Rather than simply capitulating to those requirements, however, the board determined that the best approach was to slow the process down and address these issues. In November of 2015, the reassessment certification was delayed by 90 days. To enable as many appeals and court hearings as possible. In February of this year, again faced with unresolved issues and pending appeals from the public, the board took an additional 100 days to give due process to as many taxpayers as possible. Other deadlines likewise were extended. Based on those experiences, we write to ask the district slow the construction program down and first ensure that it is truly the right approach. Please also consider the reality that shuttering two existing elementary buildings will not only be a loss for those who value neighborhood schools, but also may increase the probability of those buildings becoming blighted properties, contributing further to the devaluation of homes surrounding. There are a very explicit number of examples of what can occur when neighborhood schools are abandoned. Finally, it is our understanding that your board has not only received the resolutions from your constituent municipalities, but also been presented the signatures of nearly 2,000 taxpayers. As commissioners, we are respectfully asking that you seek and employ a slower, more measured, and cost-effective way of moving forward. We would also encourage you to consider the very precarious fiscal position of the Commonwealth, which was illustrated last week by the Department of Revenue's released financial report. In closing, we have deep respect